beings spend approximately 280 days in their mother's wombs before being born into the world. At the beginning of this process, a baby consists of just a single cell, but grows in a miraculous manner every single day. By day 22, a node in the middle of this growing body suddenly awakes. That node is your heart, which will beat without ever stopping throughout the course of your life until the day you die. This incredible organ, which starts working when you are just 3 weeks old, has a number of very important responsibilities. It gives life to the 100 trillion or so cells that comprise your entire body, enables them to breathe and take on nourishment. It cleanses and protects them from harmful agents such as bacteria, viruses, etc., and cures infected cells. Your heart does all this by ensuring that the blood in your body flows in a regular manner. Are you able to think of your contribution to establishing this astonishing system that keeps you alive? Who commanded this tiny node to start and stop beating when the appropriate time comes? It is Almighty Allah who creates this and all of the other vitally important systems in your body. Moreover, this perfect system works flawlessly together to create perfect balances for your well-being. He has created everyone who has ever lived and everyone alive today in possession of the same perfected systems. In this film, you will see the propulsive power of blood, which constantly moves through our bodies and ceaselessly brings life to our cells. And what a great blessing our hearts are, and will once again witness the existence and might of the Creator. Allah describes the might in His creation in the Quran, the divine scripture of our faith. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Do they not see that Allah, who created the heavens and the earth, has the power to create the like of them, and has appointed fixed terms for them, of which there is no doubt? But the wrongdoers still spurn anything but disbelief. The heart starts to beat when the individual is no more than a 22-day-old fetus and continues beating until the day when his or her life comes to an end. This marvelous pump will beat around 70 times a minute by synchronizing the movements of the muscles and valves. This translates to an average of 35 million times a year, and some 2 trillion times during the course of an average lifespan. The amount of blood pumped as a result is approximately 227 million liters. This amazing figure is enough to fill a 10-ton tanker a day, or the fuel tanks of 700 jumbo jets over the course of the individual's life. The heart, regarded as the most efficient machine on earth, never loses its ability to pump and distribute blood in every healthy human being, with no impairments of its rhythm. This is an extraordinary miracle of Allah, who has the power to create through the sublime artistry and perfection, with wisdom and an unmatched balance all at the same time. Our hearts are essentially lumps of muscle the size of a fist and consisting of water, fat, and protein. But that piece of muscle has a system far more flawless and perfect than any technological pump that may ever be produced by all the engineers and scientists in the world. All working together and using the most advanced technology. A miraculous feature of the heart is the way that it determines the body's requirements and pumps exactly the level of blood needed. When a person is at rest, the heart pumps a mere 4 to 6 liters a minute, which is sufficient for that individual's needs in a state of rest. The cells in the body do not require much oxygen when the body is at rest. However, a person that is exercising will require more oxygen. Thus, blood must flow faster to reach the cells. The heart is able to immediately identify this need and begins beating faster. The heart makes it possible for the blood to make 1,000 circuits around the body in a day. That means visiting all 100 trillion cells in the body 1,000 times a day, carrying the necessary nutrients, delivering oxygen and taking back carbon dioxide, repairing damage, and collecting wastes. Thanks to the heart's tireless tempo, every cell in the body is monitored 1,000 times a day, with 8,000 liters of blood being pumped every day. The heart of an adult human being is capable of pumping around 340 liters of blood in an hour, even when they are asleep. That speed would be enough to fill the fuel tank of a car within the space of 7 minutes. Find somewhere quiet and just listen to yourself. Can you hear the intense activity going on in your body? Of course not. You cannot hear anything, not even in the quietest place. Yet just 2 centimeters beneath your skin, your heart is working energetically to pump blood through a venous network stretching thousands of kilometers to even the remotest parts of the body. Under a pressure and at a speed capable of squirting that blood several meters into the air. Let us now make a comparison in order to better comprehend this perfection in the heart. Imagine that you have set up a water plant to pump at least once a second in an average of 65 to 70 times a minute. By means of that pump, water has to go to 100 trillion homes a second under the same pressure. At the same time, the plant has to determine which home needs how much water and to send more water to those requiring more. This system that has been established also has to work for at least 70 years without the slightest breakdowns or rusting. And not one of the pipelines leading to the houses must be left out of the cycle. And these are just a few of the system's important details. For several reasons, it is beyond the bounds of possibility to make such a system work. First, it is impossible for you to meet the needs of 100 trillion homes at the same time and with the same pressure. In addition, it is completely out of the question for a machine that operates at such a great speed and with an unchanging rhythm to last any longer than 10 to 15 years. Even before that, the machine would require frequent maintenance, and any defects arising would have to be put right. It is impossible for such a machine to function to perfection over the course of many years. Furthermore, it would be irrational to claim that somehow this device determined the need for each house and sent more or less water depending on its own analysis of the situation. Nobody can rationally argue that such a mechanism formed spontaneously by iron and cement mixing with one another. That is, it suddenly began pumping a random amount of water which came into being by coincidence in a rhythmic manner, and that it subsequently equipped itself with a pipeline system capable of reaching 100 trillion homes. What is obvious is that the system was in fact brought into being by a rational entity. Since it is clear that even such a poor man-made structure as compared with the heart cannot come into existence spontaneously, then there can be no doubt that the heart, with all its magnificent features, could have done so either. The heart is in every way a work of art. As we shall shortly see in detail, this unique and miraculous system manifests the sublime wisdom and power of Allah in every single detail. As we are informed in the verses of the Quran, does man reckon he will be left to go on unchecked? Was he not a drop of ejaculated sperm, then a blood clot, which he created and shaped, making from it both sexes, male and female? Is he who does this not able to bring the dead to life? The body consists of some 100 trillion cells. Each one of these cells has different tasks and properties. Some, like red blood cells or erythrocytes, have no nucleus. Others, such as those in the respiratory tract, are covered in microscopic hairs, while still others have their own engines to enable them to move about. But there is one kind of cell in the body that possesses a special attribute not to be found in any other. These cells are able to contract and expand. Special muscle cells in the heart possess this quality. The assembly of these cells suddenly go into action during the embryo stage. These cells are still able to beat after all the nerves connected to them and all connections with the surrounding organs have been severed during open heart surgery. Indeed, even when we separate just one of these cells and place it under a microscope, it will continue to pulsate as long as we nourish it with blood. What makes these cells so special is the way that they function as if they had taken a conscious decision to beat, pump blood, and keep the body alive. But what is the technical mechanism that allows these special cells to beat? Heart cells beat thanks to a low voltage electric current that passes over them. Every cell that makes up the heart is just like a living battery. They make their own chemical energy that initiates the action we refer to as the heartbeat. These processes, which are far too complex to be described in detail during this short film, cannot be explained in terms of any evolutionist claim. We can give this a more concrete form by means of an example. If you could examine the heart cells one by one under the microscope, you would see that each one beats at a different rate. This is a most astonishing and miraculous state of affairs because rather than indicating irregularity, this is actually a sign of an impeccable order. The heart beats in a rhythmic and synchronized manner. The cells literally know in line with that synchronization when to contract and when to expand. That is because Allah has inspired each one with how it needs to beat. When two heart cells beating at different rhythms come together, they immediately develop a common rhythm by means of a most extraordinary mechanism. When all the cells combine together, they assume the form of a single organ and maintain the best rhythm for the pumping of the blood. This flawless harmony among the cells is one of the proofs of our Lord's artistry. Allah is Almighty, the Lord of all. The heart has a vital working mechanism. Let us now have a closer look at this. The most important of the mechanisms in your heart are the pumps known as the atrium and ventricles on its right and left. It is the responsibility of the left atrium and ventricle to distribute the oxygenated blood arriving to the heart, to the organs and tissues. The right atrium and ventricle are responsible for sending the dirty or oxygen-depleted blood to the lungs for cleaning. When oxygenated blood reaches the heart, it first passes to a small pump in the upper part, or the left atrium. From there, it is passed onto a large pump beneath, which is the left ventricle. Similarly, deoxygenated or dirty blood is passed from the right atrium to the right ventricle. Everything here needs to take place in the right order. If that order is damaged, either no or too much blood will be pumped through the body. There are valves between the atria and ventricles to permit the sequence to take place properly. These valves open in only one direction, that of the flow of blood. When the atria contract, these valves open and blood fills the ventricle. Once this process has taken place, the valves close to prevent the blood flowing back to where it came from. Similar valves are also present in the ventricles. When ventricles contract, the valves open and let the blood flow directly to the body. When the pumping process stops, the valves close and blood is thus prevented from returning to the heart. The sound we perceive as the heartbeat is not contrary to what most people imagine, the sound emerging as the result of the heart's contraction and dilation. What we are actually hearing is a powerful opening and closing of these four valves. This impeccable system proves that the heart and the circulatory system could not have emerged as the result of chance, but were created by a sublime power. That power belongs to Almighty Allah, Lord of the heavens and the earth. The timing of the heart also constitutes a flawless structure and order. This is established by the coordination and communication among the cells that comprise the heart. A sublime intelligence is manifested in the cells. These cells transmit a current to the other side of the heart at a speed of approximately 60 centimeters a second. The production of the signal is astonishingly quick. 1/14th of a second. As the current moves quickly, it sets the two atria in motion and enables these to contract in order to collect blood. Just when the electrical impulse is about to reach the ventricular muscles, it is halted by specialized cells in the muscle tissue between the right atrium and the right ventricle. This causes a delay in the flow of the current to reach the ventricle, and the speed of the current falls to 20 centimeters a second. This delay is exceedingly important because due to it, the atrium pumps the blood and is empty completely before the ventricle contracts. This is the secret behind the synchronized action of the heart. What you are watching is just one of the countless details inherent in the heart's electrical system. The slightest interruption to this system, with its miraculous features, will lead to blood not reaching the organs or else reaching them late. This will give rise to very serious consequences. Indeed, a human being will faint if blood fails to reach the brain for any longer than 4 or 5 seconds. And if this is prolonged still further, the result is death. In light of all these characteristics, we can see that the heart is a conscious being that produces its own energy and employs it to work in a most synchronized and harmonious manner. This action begins as a tiny node consisting of a limited number of cells, and that collection of cells knows at what speed they need to transmit the current. Otherwise, the heart would be unable to do its job and stop pumping blood. At the same time, the heart accurately determines the amount of electrical current it produces. If even an immeasurably small amount of current were to pass through the region in an uncontrolled manner, the result would once again be death. In addition, the heart can regulate its own synchronization. In the cardiac cells aligned side by side, the cell with the fastest rhythm of expansion and contraction keeps the others in synchronization. If this rhythm is impaired, if one cell expands as the other contracts, the requisite pumping will fail to take place. The heart will soon stop, leading to death within a matter of seconds. In short, the heart is made up of special cells that constantly produce their own energy, coordinate the blood flow, expand and contract, regulate electrical currents in themselves, and are also able to plan, calculate, take precautionary measures, and act rapidly in emergency situations. Such a magnificent arrangement is obviously not the work of chance, but belongs to a superior wisdom. The heart nourishes the entire body, and like all other organs, it too needs to be nourished. Moreover, because of its vital function, the heart needs more oxygen and nutrients. However, the heart muscle is too thick and tight to absorb nutrients and oxygen. That means the heart is unable to benefit from the blood vessels running through it. So how is this vitally important organ fed? The heart possesses a special apparatus that nourishes it, known as the coronary circulation. The heart itself is the first recipient of the blood that emerges from the heart by way of the coronary arteries. Coronary arteries are two separate branches of the aorta that carries the cleanest and most oxygen-rich blood from the lungs. The distinguishing feature of these arteries is that they were created solely in order to nourish the heart. In contrast to other arteries, the coronary arteries leave the heart and then return to it instead of leading to other organs in the body. In this way, the most oxygen-rich blood nourishes the heart without going anywhere else, just as if it had identified the heart as the organ requiring the greatest amount of oxygen. Since the heart cells turn oxygen and sugar into energy in order to be able to function, the blood in the coronary arteries has to be rich in these substances, because the heart's energy consumption is regulated in line with its needs and can rise 4 or 5-fold in a matter of seconds. The coronary arteries have been perfectly equipped for their job. These arteries that enter the heart spread all through it by dividing and subdividing into smaller branches like those of a tree. Every cell that constitutes the heart needs a constant supply of nutrients and oxygen. As these arteries head towards the heart, they also establish sublinks with one another. This detail is highly important because if any of the arteries become obstructed in one way or another, the heart cannot be nourished and will die. These subconnections are an important precautionary measure against that threat. Thanks to this precaution, if one artery becomes blocked, the blood can continue along the others, bypassing the obstruction and thus reaching the heart. At this point, we need to ask the following question. Could chance have thought of the possibility of the arteries becoming blocked? Could it have decided to take such precaution at a time when that threat did not yet even exist? That is, of course, impossible. Coincidences are random and unconscious events that leave no room for conscious intervention. This order, present in all living things, including human beings, belongs to Allah who creates them and knows all their details. Our Lord has set this truth out in the Quran. Glorify the name of your Lord, the Most High, He who created and molded, He who determined and guided. Many people are completely unaware of the flawless balances that operate non-stop within their bodies. Not one of these balances is ever impaired for any reason. People thus live their lives without encountering problems. The fact remains, however, that there are countless such balances and systems that must always remain stable for a person to stay alive and be healthy. The heart is one of the most important of these. There are many factors that can have a damaging impact on this equilibrium, but there is order established to keep these systems and balances stable. For instance, the fact that the amount of blood leaving the heart is the same as that returning to it is impeccably crucial and pertinent for a person's survival. Let us assume that this equilibrium has been impaired. In that case, since the blood sent into the body cannot return, it will collect in various locations. This will lead to edemas in various parts of the body and to injuries resulting from bursting blood vessels. Since insufficient blood returns to the heart, the level of oxygenated blood will be fairly low, and the amount of oxygen-rich blood to be sent from the heart will be insufficient to nourish the body. If this process, this imbalance, persists, the organs of the body will begin to die from malnutrition. Anyone using their proper reasoning ability when evaluating this highly complex state of just one system out of the many different systems in the body will grasp one very important truth. The conclusion can only be that we are looking at a magnificent perfection, many times in excess of what a human intelligence is able to conceive. Anyone analyzing all of this with a sincere and open mind will immediately see the absolute existence and sovereignty of our Almighty Lord. This extraordinary mechanism in the heart is, as revealed in verses, the work of Allah who created you and formed you and proportioned you, and who is the creator, the maker, the giver of form. Allah has created human beings and has made these countless complex mechanisms in the body as proofs of His creation. These perfections we have been looking at since the start of this film are all intended to reveal the existence of Almighty Allah in all places and that His magnificent works are present in our bodies. People who refuse to see these obvious facts will see the error of their ways in the hereafter. They reward in the presence of Allah for having ignored the many proofs shown to them, and even seeking alternative explanations for these may be a very painful one. Allah has prepared an eternal life of hell for those who knowingly deny Him. A rational person must consider the reality of the hereafter and stop to think and seriously fear the punishments of hell. This is how Allah describes the position of those who enter the hereafter in a state of denial. The true promise is very close. The eyes of those who were unbelievers will be transfixed. Alas for us, we were unmindful of this. No, rather we were definitely wrongdoers.